And guys, welcome to another episode of Tactical Tuesday. I'm sorry that I was not able to post a video last week. If some of y'all did not read my message on my channel, I was out all day Monday celebrating my mother's birthday. So Tactical Tuesday had to wait for mother's sake. So celebrating her birthday. So we were gone all day and I wasn't able to post anything. But I went ahead and let you guys know about that. But now I'm coming with another video. But as a heads up, this coming Tuesday, I will not be coming out with another episode. Because, actually, tomorrow, we are, me and my family are going camping. Going into the wild and whatever, tent camping. And we'll be coming back Monday. However, Tuesday, we're going to be unloading all the stuff, so I really won't have time to post that. So, I'm just letting y'all know, and I promise, you know, Tactical Tuesday ain't going to fall into the depths, so I'm going to continue it. So, for today's episode, I was thinking about that, and I was like, well, should I go with another Pike and Shotte one? Should I go with maybe Black Power, whatever? But I decided that I think I would get into a topic that I have heard it has been, like, sweeping the nation, maybe. USA, Britain, game that y'all have probably heard of from Oilers games called Bolt Action. It's a World War II war games rules done by Alessio. It was written by Alessio Cavatore, I believe so. Alessio Cavatore. If I get your name wrong, please forgive me. I'm horrible at pronouncing names like that. Sorry. And Rick Priestley, as all of y'all know, of Games Workshop fame for, I'm not sure if he did Warhammer. I'm not sure. But I know that he did some of Warhammer 40,000. So, pretty famous wargamer. And him and Alessio got together and made up this war game. I had bought this book quite a while back, and I skimmed through it. At first I didn't really have the interest in it, but then as I began looking at the forums and reading about people playing the game and stuff, it started to sound a lot more interesting. And so I've begun to reread the rule book, and it's looking really interesting. Unfortunately, I think the reason why Bolt Action is literally just sweeping everywhere, I mean, people are picking this up like crazy, from what I've heard, is that since it's a shooty game, and World War II, who doesn't like World War II? It's gaining a lot more fame than stuff like Black Powder or Pike and Shotte, I believe. And I've heard people say that it's pretty much like the second edition of Warhammer 40,000. Now, the thing about I'll quickly skim over these the rule systems and such and let y'all know, and maybe it'll perk your interest. I am thinking if I can find anyone in my area about maybe going in the direction of Bolt Action. I'm not giving up on Pike and Shotte, but I probably won't move in that direction as much as with Bolt Action, because I think this would have more popularity in the communities and such. So anyway, so a quick review of the book. Pretty much, I mean, it's shitty, it's fun, and it has its own taste. Now, as we all probably know, Warlord Games game mechanics has all their games have the orders type, 2d6, roll against your leadership. If you make lower to or equal, if you make lower or equal to your leadership, you pass the order and they obey your command. This game, it's not as heavily on that, which is a saver, but it certainly does have that in there. In the game, they have what you call order dice. Each unit is given a, with each unit you have, you have specific order dies. Dice, I should say. And to demonstrate, each unit, you know, they have their own orders. You can't, with this game, unlike, say, Warhammer 40,000, you just take your guys and you do whatever. You know, you have movement phase, shooting phase, and close quarters, I believe. You know, you just move them wherever you want to. If you got opponents in range, you shoot them. And then if you're in range, you can assault. Something like that. With this, you have to give them explicit orders. And how you do this is that you give them an order die. Each unit has its own order die. And with how many units you have in the game is how many order dies you have. Now, something very interesting with how they made this is that the turns are actually very... There's a turn, but who goes first is very irregular. For most gamers, probably. Because how it is done, it's not just, oh, I go first, I move all my guys, shoot, assault. Okay, now it's your turn. You know, it's my... it's the top of turn one for me, it's the bottom for turn, you know, one for you. It's not done like that. It's all done with the usage of your order dies. Pretty much think of your order dies as your initiative, you could say. And also what orders you want to give to your troops. So say if you have six units, you would get six order dies. And if your opponent has eight units, he would get eight order dies. And what you would do is that you would take them, you would take them all, and you would put them just when I need something, I can't find it. Anyway, that's what I have to do. But what you would do is that you would put them in a cup, you know, and it can be either, you know, you or maybe an umpire or a person just participating, he can pull out the dice. But what you're going to do is that you're going to put them in this cup. You want to shake them up, get them all, you know, shaken up, duh. And then you pick up one die and see whose it is. Now, usually with whichever army you have, it will be a specific color. For instance, if you're the Germans, it will be gray. If you're the Americans, it will be green. So after he shakes it all up and then he picks out the die, if it's a green, Americans go first. So that so the American player can take that die and give one of his units an order. So then, after he's given the order and done everything he needs to, shakes it up again, picks it up. Oh, look, it's the green's turn again. Gives it the green player, he gives the unit another order. After he's done completing that, well, shake it up again. Oh, look, a German order. So that's how it's done. And that's very interesting because with how many order dies you have shows like a higher initiative. You know, if you have more dies than your opponent, then you probably have more of a chance of going first and be able to get to, you know, the objective or whatever. But it's quite interesting how to do that. So now you're saying, well, what do the order dies do? You know, well, an order die is six-sided, and it will have the orders that you can give them. Going from one to six, there is fire. And number one is fire. Number two is advance. Number three is run. Number four is ambush. Number five is rally. And number six is down. Now, fire is pretty much like a default move. It's pretty much fire at full effect without moving. So pretty much the unit doesn't move at all. They just sit there and they, you know, the squad doesn't, you know, they don't move. They just shoot. Oh, by the way, something that I did forget to mention is that in bolt action, there is no, you know, multiple guys on one base. It is all individual. So with how many men you have in the squad and how many casualties you take, like if you take four casualties, you subtract four men. So they do use individual soldiers as individuals and not just, you know, the unit as a whole or something like that. Like with Pike and Shotte and such. Just wanted to mention that. Number two is advance. Advance is moving and firing. Now infantry have a movement of 6 inches. With advance, you give them an order, and they advance 6 inches, and then they fire. However, when you do that, you have a chance of, you have a -1 to-hit penalty. Because, you know, this is like the guy's moving, so then they get in their position, they're like, oh, whew, bam, you know, they're going to not not going to be that accurate in that. Number three is run. Now, and that is move at double speed without firing, also used for assaulting. So if you were, so if you didn't want to shoot, and you wanted to get to a position very quickly, which is actually double your speed, which is 1 foot, you would, you know, you would get them order and they would just run, no shooting or whatever. But you would also use this if you were going to assault an opponent. For instance, if there was an opponent, you know, 6 inches away, you would use the assault move. I mean, you would use the run move to assault him. The run order, I should say. Number four is ambush. And this is no move, slash fire, but wait for opportunity to fire. Now, this is actually one that was sort of hard to get for. I wasn't able to get it at first. But pretty much what it is that when you set a unit on ambush, it's almost like setting them on overwatch over this position. And so if you set them in ambush, let's say you had your American squad right here, and you set them on ambush. And the Germans were over here, and they couldn't, the Americans can't shoot at them right now. But the Germans decide to run up to this fence right here, which is all the way over here. Now with ambush, they would still retain their order in that turn. They wouldn't go back into the dice cup after they were done with their with all the moving. It would still stay there. But what this does is that this allows the American player to interrupt the movement of that unit anytime he wants to. So pretty much he can catch, if the American squad is on ambush, he can catch the Germans out in the open when they're running. And so that's a pretty interesting and useful, I believe. Number five is rally. Now, and that's no move, fire, but lose D6 pin markers. Now, in bolt action, there is a very interesting mechanic, which is pinning. Now, I'm sure if some of you, if you've played Flames of War and stuff, and you've probably heard of being pinned. But, you know, with pin units, that's them taking a lot of fire and, you know, getting down to the earth and not getting up to shoot, you know, just trying to, you know, they're in all the classic World War and two old films, you know, standing there saying, you know, Mother Mary, help me, you know, all that stuff. You know, that's pretty much what they're doing. Now, whenever you're shooting at a unit, if you make one or more hits, you cause a pin. And a pin has an effect on the unit's shooting and on their morale. So, if a unit has a morale of 9, and they take a pin marker, they will have, their morale of 9 will be reduced to a morale of 8. If they take 3 pin markers, their morale of 9 will be reduced to 6. So, and also their shooting. I'll get into shooting later. Let me check the time on this. If I was to go over all in bolt action, it would take quite a while. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to give you the first overview of it. But it would have an effect on your shooting as well. Now, to shoot at a target, it's a 3+. However, that's going to rarely be the case because there's going to be a lot of factors into shooting. A 3+ is saying, like, in the book, they say the 3+ stands for them, you know, sitting down, they're not distracted by the battle, and they're taking good aim. However, that's rarely going to be the case because either that unit's going to be behind cover, the squad's going to have some pins on it maybe, they're going to be at long range, so usually you will end up hitting on the 5 or 6 plus. So it's never really going to be a 3 plus. It's never going to be an easy shot unless you're up close and dirty. Pretty much like that. So whenever you take a pin, and your pins can mount up a lot. It's like some units can end up having like 5 pins or something like that. The rally order is allowing them to lose D6 pin markers. So if you have 5 pin markers and you order them to rally and you successfully make your leadership, you take your dice and you roll it, and I just got a 2. So then I would lose 2 pin markers. Now that's not a really good roll. I would still have 3 left. So, that's what rally is. And then finally, down is no move slash fire, but gain one extra negative one to hit. That's another factor of, you know, not being able to hit a target well. If the unit has not received an order for that turn and they're shot at, they can go down. This is them, you know, hugging the earth and, you know, praying that they're not going to get hit. That is what down stands for. So six orders and such. Now, if a unit does not have any pin markers on them, they're not pinned or anything like that, then the order will be passed automatically. It's just you move them or you fire or whatever. However, if you have one or more pin markers, it will require a leadership check. And that's sort of where, you know, the Warlord mechanics get in, you know, from the other games. But that's pretty much what it is, and it's interesting to see how your morale will go down. It's very interesting how they do that. Man, that's a lot I would like to talk about, but good grief, there's a lot. But it's very, pretty much this is just a brief overview. Maybe next time I do Tactical Tuesday, I will go into more if y'all want, or if you want me to focus on something else, then that's completely up to you. But it is a very interesting game, and I think it would be very, very fun. I know the Warlord Games is really excited about it. That's one of the biggest things that they're into, is bolt action. But I do believe it's a very good game. It's, for those players that like to have points and like to give, you know, different war gear options to their troops, you know, give them upgrades or whatever, this is the best of Warlord Games for that. Because, you know, you can buy squads at different levels and such. You know, you can get Rangers, which are veterans, you know, they have leadership of 10, you know. You can almost deck out half of the squad in some machine guns, which, you know, have two shots each, you know, or there's just a whole bunch of stuff. And they're coming out with a lot of armies. I mean, they got America, Britain, Russia, Germany, Italy, France, Japan, Poles, I believe. I'm not really sure. They're coming out with just a whole bunch of stuff. It is amazing. But anyway, so that's a quick overview on bolt action. I hope you all enjoyed this video. As always, it's a pleasure to do Tactical Tuesday. I'm glad to get the voice out there and let you all know about it. If you all have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment box below. And just reminding y'all, I will not be doing another video this coming, another Tactical Tuesday this coming Tuesday, because I will be busy, very, very busy. So just want to let y'all know about that. So anyway, guys, as always, have a nice day. Cheerio.